Our number one economic issue is jobs. If everybody's employed or lots of people are employed, a lot of these problems go away because you're not supporting people. People are paying taxes. Your fellow congressmen are not helping the situation, and you don't trust the Fed. So what's the fix?
Well, they haven't done their job, and you know, they're supposed to have full employment or take care of unemployment, and they've done a lousy job, so I don't know why we can trust them to do something that, quite frankly, they're incapable of doing. They can't practice central economic planning through management of money and credit, and I think we're seeing the results. They can create a bubble, and they can, you know, they can create times that look good, but they're artificial, they're distorted, there's malinvestment, and you do have inflation now that people don't admit to. And you know, you said that I don't want the Fed to fix the economy. I want to fix the economy, but we could fix the economy if we had not had the Fed trying to manage the economy for a long time.
Now, if the Fed were to get out of the way, what would that lead to? What would happen? You say that assets are mispriced and interest rates are too low. Right. What would the world look like, and how would it happen?
Well, it can't happen overnight, and that isn't my position. I want to transition away from it, but I would legalize competition. If people get very disgusted with the dollar in the financial system, and just look at what the dollar is doing right now, I mean, this is these recent announcements just devaluing the dollar. But we ought to have the right to practice free market economics and follow the Constitution, allow gold and silver to be legal tender rather than putting people in jail if they want to do that. If you want to look at what it might be like without a Federal Reserve, look to the latter part of the 19th century, early part of the 20th century, and that is the period of time where we had the most economic growth
ever. So let me ask you this,
though.
I hear you, but there's so much that was so different about the latter part of the 19th century and the early part of the 20th century, most people can't relate to that. So is there?
Well, they should. They should work on it.
Congressman, you're asking me to relate to a place where I didn't have a BlackBerry and we didn't have the internet.
But you can read.
Didn't have airplanes.
You can read history.
I'm unconvinced about how I'm going to. We didn't have proper plumbing. So let's talk about, is there a contemporary example of a place that does not have that sort of monetary involvement, you know, central bank involvement, that works better? Is there a place? Is there such a?
Well, no, but I think your question is a crucial question, and it also explains why this is a worldwide global phenomenon and why the whole world is engulfed in a situation that is very difficult, because we have used the dollar as the reserve currency of the world. They put it in the bank as if it's gold. They still trust the dollar, allow us to print a lot of money, and believing that you can get out of this trouble with debt and spending and all the problems we have by just printing more money.
The Fed was trying to fix things in the economy. You say that they're not an effective tool to do that, but they're trying to increase unemployment. Congress isn't really helping on that front. Do you believe Congress could have a bigger role in supporting and growing employment in this country?
Oh, absolutely. Congress is the culprit, and they're allied with the Fed, because the Congress is always too involved. Too much regulations, too much taxes, too much spending. But the spending wouldn't occur if you didn't have the Fed, because the members of Congress are politicians, and they spend money, and they won't cut because they're afraid they'll lose the next election. But if you have the Fed standing ready, they are the moral hazard, because they're always ready to buy the debt. So there's no incentive under these circumstances for a politician to spend less. So if they want to be the run the American empire around the world, no reason to back off for economic reasons. If you want the welfare state forever, no reason to back off until the collapse comes. So I'm trying to come back to a sane policy and try to prevent the collapse of the dollar.
Let me ask you this. You've refused to fully endorse Mitt Romney. He says, by the way, he supports an audit of the Fed. He says he wouldn't reappoint Ben Bernanke as Fed chairman. He's criticized the latest round of Fed stimulus, QE3. Is there something Mitt Romney could do to get your support?
Probably not at this stage, because I'm concerned as much about the foreign policy as domestic policy and monetary policy. But I feel good that he and I have had discussions on the Fed, and he has made some statements, and he supports, you know, this position now about auditing the Fed. So I would say that is very good. But there, you know, we had a lot of debates, and we got along quite well, but we had a lot of disagreements on the policy of what the role of government ought to be.